How do you feel about that? A new desire. Again and again and again. It's what life is, isn't it? Those desires that continue to hatch within you. Do you believe in your ability to receive them? When you do, those desires feel good, don't they? Do you ever have a desire? Do you hold any desires right now that you've been holding for so long? They annoy you? I want to enjoy wanting this, but I've wanted it for so long, and it has been so slow in coming or so long in not coming that now it's sort of a sore spot. I don't want to run into that friend who's going to say, "Hey, how about that? Did it happen?" So I've been avoiding that friend. Sorry I ever told that friend that I wanted that. Because that friend seems like an ever-present presence to remind me that I'm failing at this most important thing that I want. We're poking around at this with a stick to make it a little sore for you, because we want you by the end of this day to come round to feeling exhilaration about each and every so far yet unfulfilled, not yet manifested desire that you hold. We want you to feel good about those things you desire that have not come into your physical manifested experience. Because by the end of this gathering, we want you to understand why they have not come. And more important, we want you to know where to focus in order to allow them to come. But all of this is not for the purpose of helping you to manifest desires that are currently stubborn and slow in coming. The whole point of all of it is so that you can ease up on that tension that you feel in what isn't yet here. Because if you can figure out how to give yourself a break, how to ease up on the tension you feel for unfulfilled desires, if you can feel easier about things that you want that haven't come, or about things that you want, things that are currently in your experience that you want not, that you can't yet figure out how to get rid of, if you can come to this place where you feel ease, even though the manifestation has not yet caught up with the desire, then we will have done the work that we came here to do. Because we know that when you find a way of coming into alignment, which means letting go of tension, coming into alignment, which means lining up with ease, coming into alignment, which means letting go of regret, coming into alignment, which means finding self-love. When you find a way of letting go of grudges and find a way to come into alignment with the lover that you are, when you are able to come into alignment with the whole that is you, then your world will feel good right now. And after all, that's why you want everything you want, isn't it? Isn't every single thing you want, whether it's a material object or a state of being or a pile of money or a relationship or a circumstance or an event, isn't every single thing you want because you believe in the having of it, you will feel better? And we just want to help you get it turned around in your own mind so that you can feel it in your own being. We just want you to remember that if you can get yourself to find a way of feeling good, regardless of what's going on. And by that, we don't mean look at awful things and feel good about them. We say find a way of feeling good no matter what's going on, which is really about focusing. It's about focusing toward what feels as good as you can find. Focusing as best you can toward what feels as good as you can find it. If you can do that, then you can train, and we mean that in every literal sense, you can train your own vibrational patterns into harmony with who you really are and what you really want. And that's what causes a releasing of tension, because that's what causes a releasing of resistance. It's resistance to who you are, meaning resistance to who you are with all of the things that you've been asking for. It's resistance to who you have become that equals negative emotion. So your negative emotion is not your enemy. Negative emotion is your very best friend, because your negative emotion is pointing right at your self-inflicted, and it is every time, self-inflicted resistance, which is the only thing that is holding you apart from who you really are and all of the things that you want.